Stop talking about comic books or I'll kill you. I don't care if the Hulk could defeat the man.
Hey, hey there, comic fam. Bullseye Bob here, and welcome to Everything Comics. And this is just kind of an impromptu episode because I'm going to be doing some things here on the channel that are kind of not comic book related. And I just kind of wanted to explain that because there's a special thing that's happening this week and I'm so excited for it, you guys. So let's go ahead and get into it. So this Friday on Amazon Prime, the first three episodes of the Wheel of Time series is going to be starting. And I am so excited for this. I have a long history with those books and the Wheel of Time series by Robert Jordan. And I just kind of wanted to get on here and kind of tell you how long I've been into the series, my love for it, all the different angles and things I've done when it comes to the characters in these books and this amazing series that has been out for a number of years. Because this is huge, you know? I mean, I waited my whole life for Lord of the Rings and all of these Marvel properties to come to the big screen with special effects that could do them justice. And so here's another property that I've been into for years that they're bringing to the screen, and I'm so excited for it. So just if you guys, some of you may not know, but I'm a huge fantasy reader. I love fantasy. You know, when I was very young, I was given the Lord of the Rings series, and that kind of started my love relationship with reading fantasy novels. I really got into Michael Moorcock, you know, the Elric of Milnibone stories. I absolutely loved those. Later on, I went in and got into all the Dragonlance stuff, which was amazing. And then also the Forgotten Realms stuff. I'm a huge Drizzt Do'Urden fan. I got into what do they call it? Sword of Truth series, which was just absolutely amazing. The Shannara series. There are so many great ones, and I've been into them all. But Wheel of Time was kind of one of those series that was a cut above, was so special, especially when it came out. And then as it went along, it just kept getting better and better. And so, I don't know, I think I first started reading The Wheel of Time when actually book three came out, because I had seen it and I had gotten used to over time just waiting for the third book to drop in series, because most of them are trilogies. And so when Wheel of Time first came out, I held off on reading book one, I held off on reading book two, and waited for book three. So, because I'm one of those type of people that hates to wait for the next book to come out, you know, once I have gotten to the end of the last book. And so that didn't work too well for me for this particular series. Because, as you know, there are, I think, 14 or 15 of these books, and they're all huge. And when you look at the paperbacks, I mean, they're huge. Over 1,000 pages each. And but anyway, I read the first three books and I just absolutely fell in love with it. Robert Jordan had a way of being able to take all these elements from history and mythos and fantasy novels and science fiction and putting it all together in this amazing world that he built. He really laid out governments and lands and, I mean, characteristics of people groups and ethnicities and all these different things. And the premise of the story, if you've never read it before, I'll just kind of give you, you know, how he approached it, is this. What if somebody came and tapped you on the shoulder and told you that you were savior of the world? How would you react to that? And then also, when the world found out, how would they react to you? And that's the premise of the story. And he's a prolific writer in the way that he built the world that he wanted to write in so that he had a sandbox to play in. And he started writing the story with the ending in mind. So he knew exactly where he wanted to go with it. And like I said, I started reading the first three books. When I got to the third book, I realized this story isn't over, not by a long shot. And I mean, over the years, every book that came out, I ended up going back and rereading the book so that I could get caught up, so that I could read the next one. And so I've read it multiple times. And every time I read it, I loved it even more. I got so much more out of it. And so I've been reading these books for years. Now, one of the things that happens inside of these books is it gets so involved with all these different prophecies and things like that that are coming about, and omens and all sorts of things like that. And so you kind of get into what these things mean. And there were also mysteries to be solved within the books. Like there was a character who got killed mysteriously, and for the longest time we had no idea who it was that killed that character, but that was a topic of conversation inside of the series for the longest time, was who killed this character. It's so much fun. And at one point, I think around book five, I started getting involved with discussion groups. There were tons and tons of discussion groups back in the mid-90s to early 2000s. And they all would go over all of the different things that were open-ended in those books, so that, you know, people could kind of predict what they were or what they meant or what they believed was going to happen, or clues that told you certain things inside of here. And so I had a binder that I used to carry with me that had all these things inside of it from the discussion groups. And I used to love sitting there inside of some of these things and talking about what was going on inside of the books. I had a group of friends that I could sit and talk with for hours on it. So I really got involved with it. Then in around 1999, they came out with the Wheel of Time video game. Now, it was supposed to be a massive multiplayer online role-playing game, kind of like World of Warcraft, that type of thing. But the technology just wasn't there at the time, so they drummed it down into a first-person shooter. And it was one of the greatest gaming experiences I've ever had in my life. And I played games since the beginning, but nothing was ever as great as the online experience that I had with that game. It wasn't just a first-person shooter where you could choose between 10 different guns that you pick up. No, there were 20 different weapons inside of this game, and they were all offensive and defensive, and they were picked up by spawns, and they only had a certain amount of shots in each one. But they were all based on the magic system from the Wheel of Time, which is based on air, earth, fire, water, and air, and spirit. So there were six different ones. And the different weaves of that power made up certain things. And these items carried one of those weaves. They were called Terangriel. You used to pick them up. And so imagine playing a first-person shooter where you just didn't shoot at people, but you also had defensive weapons as well. I could fire things off that would grab a hold and seek people out as they were running around, and they could take and use this thing called reflect and reflect it back at me. I could throw up a shield, and that would different. Then they had different types of shields that would, you know, take out some of these different weaves. You could shift through walls. You could trade places with people. And then they also had magic that you could use for sniping. And it was the most incredible experience when they had the, what they called, it was kind of like a, capture the flag type thing, but you had two different bases. There were seals that you had to capture inside of these bases, and then a mid-world that you could battle it out. And I belonged to a clan inside of that gaming system, the Black Tower. And in the books, the Black Tower are made up of males who can channel this thing called the One Power. And you know, I'm not a prolific gamer. I'm not like really, you know, good, but I held my own, had lots of fun. And I was actually responsible for creating a battle system for our clan to use when using this capture the flag type deal. And we were the clan to beat. We got so good that actually the creators of the game formed a team to go up against us. And it was like the Super Bowl. But I did that for 3 years straight and loved every minute of it. And it's part of this whole Wheel of Time experience. As a matter of fact, if any of you are watching this and you played that Wheel of Time game and you were part of that online experience, if you were in a clan and you played up against the Black Tower, do me a favor and leave who you are down in the comments. I'd love to connect with you. But this was part of the whole Wheel of Time experience. I even got into writing fan fiction. Because as we were playing the game, all, you know, the love of this stuff from other people, it was just infectious. And people were writing fan fiction, so I wrote some myself. I think the first cosplay that I ever did was a character from the Wheel of Time. But here we are, all these years later, and they have ordered up from Amazon Prime the Wheel of Time. Now, when they first announced this, I was very skeptical, because the way it was announced was this: Jeff Bezos, who was the owner of Amazon at the time, he basically said he wanted his version of Game of Thrones. And I thought, if they Game of Thrones Wheel of Time, I'll be very upset, because that is not the same type of thing. It was not written the way George R.R. Martin wrote the Game of Thrones. You can't do that to the Wheel of Time. So if that type of stuff happens in this show, I'll be highly disappointed and I won't be watching it. But having said that, ever since they announced it, like I said, I've been skeptical. But as we've been moving along, I keep getting glimpses and seeing trailers. And now that I've seen just about every trailer that's come out, and I've read some of the reviews of the first three episodes that are going to drop this Friday, I am so excited for this and I can't wait. So I'm going to be doing basically episode reviews of the Wheel of Time series as each episode comes out. Join me for that. If you've never seen, if you've never read the books before, I believe they're doing it in such a way that you don't have to have read the books to watch the series, but I'd highly recommend that you do. I'd even more highly recommend that you'd read the books, because they are incredible. Don't let the size of them, put you off. They are an incredible read. They'll keep you on the edge of your seat. They're so rich in the way that they're formed, and it's a great reading experience. And so, one of the things that I did recently, just to let you know, if you go over to my good buddy Jason from Heroes to Icons on his channel, just in the last couple of weeks, we did a review of book number one of The Wheel of Time, which is called The Eye of the World. And that's pretty much what we're going to get in the first season of this series, The Wheel of Time, is The Eye of the World. I'm very excited about it. But here's the thing. Go check out that view. If you've read the books already, go check out that video. Check out our discussion. We had a great time. I think we reviewed the whole book. It took us about 2 hours. And to me, it was just going down memory lane. I have not reread the books in a number of years now. It's probably been about, 8 years since I've touched those books. But as we were going along, I remembered everything just like I was reading it for the first time, because I've read them so many times. So go check out that discussion. It's really great. But if you have never read the books, check them out. They're incredible. Definitely watch the series. I am so excited for this. That's going to be a new facet of the channel going forward. And I just kind of wanted to get on and let you guys know where it's coming from and why I'm doing this, because it's not technically comic book related, even though there are Wheel of Time comics that were done. I think they were done by Dynamite. I don't have any of those Wheel of Time comics. And when I look on eBay, a bunch of them are really high in price, and because they're very low print run. And there's no way I'm going to be able to collect those. But if you know anybody who has a bunch of those that they're looking to get rid of them for, I'd love to take them off their hands, but I can't pay those exorbitant prices. I'd go for buying a collection for a decent price. But I eventually would love to get the Wheel of Time comic books. And so anyway, check out the Wheel of Time series coming out on Amazon Prime this Friday. The first three episodes are going to drop. And my excitement is just too much. I couldn't go on without maybe throwing up something so you guys understood where I was going with all this. And do me a favor, leave me a comment down in the comment section. Let me know, are you excited for the show? Or maybe you're interested in seeing it for the first time, that you're maybe not a reader, but you're definitely willing to check it out. Let me know what you think about The Wheel of Time, because it's a series that has really touched me in many ways, and I've made many relationships over it, just like I have done here in the comic book community. And it's a wonderful and rich series. So in between time, I will be probably putting out a review video this week. I haven't done one of those in a long time. I'm really looking forward to that. But the channel is up and rolling again, people, and I'm very happy to be back. So thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for listening to me. Definitely check out the series this week and the discussions going forward. Also, I know From Heroes to Icons is going to be doing reaction or review videos with Jason and his daughter. And Jason being a longtime reader of the series and his daughter never reading the series, it'll be interesting in getting both of their perspectives on those videos. So definitely check out his channel as well. There's a lot of Wheel of Time goodness that's going to be going around, and I really hope that this thing blows up, because it's incredible. Anyway, we'll see you guys next time. Remember, support your local comic shop, and Excelsior, folks. We'll see you later.
I don't care if the Hulk could defeat the Man of Steel.